I hope all of you are fit and fine. Your pre-half-yearly unit test is almost here. It's knocking at the door. I hope your preparation is almost done, because we have been revising the portion, the pre-half-yearly portion, for almost 2 weeks, right? And I just hope that the revision worksheets, they have helped you in your preparation to some extent at least. Okay, so today this video is going to be a very short one, because I have already discussed all the important portions again and again. I have clarified your doubts till now, the doubts that you had. Even after that, you may have some doubts, some confusions, and today we are going to give the last live class before your test. So please note your whatever doubts, confusions you have, please note them down. We will discuss them in the live class. Okay, today I am going to discuss the answers of today's worksheet. Okay, one more thing. I think in the previous worksheet, I think there were some problems with it. I don't know, there the numbers of the questions were not put accordingly. I don't know what happened, but don't worry, I have tried to include all the important topics of that question paper in today's worksheet. Okay, and today I am going to discuss the worksheet in today's video in the same, on the same day, because we will not get any other class. Okay, so in today's worksheet, the first question was, in the story, the three questions, Dash brought fresh water for the wounded man. Who brought fresh water for that injured man? The king brought fresh water for that wounded man. Leo Tolstoy was a famous Dash writer. There were three options, I guess, American, Indian, and none of these. Obviously, the correct answer will be none of these, because Leo Tolstoy was neither Indian nor American. Rather, he was a famous Russian author, right? So he was a Russian author. So in this particular question, none of the options gets matched. So the correct option will be none of these. Okay. Number three. What is the color of clouds mentioned in the poem Palm Tree? I have revised this question various times. This is very important. So the color of clouds mentioned in the poem Palm Tree is gray. If you go through the poem thoroughly, minutely, you will get to know that the color of the clouds mentioned in this particular poem is gray. In number four, in which narrative point of view the author is a character of the story? We all know the answer. The first person narrative point of view. I have discussed this so many times, but again I would like to repeat it, because there were many students who were confused about this particular question, and I received so many wrong answers as the answer of this particular question. What did I say? There were two narrative points of view. First person narrative point of view, third person narrative point of view. No second person point of view. We are not reading pronoun, not grammar. So no second person, only first person narrative point of view and third person narrative point of view. What happens in the first person narrative view? That we can see in an autobiography, where the narrator or the writer is a character of that story itself. Okay, so in first person narrative point of view, the narrator or the writer is a character of the story itself. But in third person narrative point of view, what happens? As we can see in the three questions by Leo Tolstoy, it is written in the third person narrative point of view. Why do we say so? Because in third person narrative point of view, the narrator or the author is not a character of that story. The writer or the author just narrates. events with which he or she doesn't have any link. He or she just narrates those events. Okay. The author is nowhere found inside that story. Okay. So in third person narrative point of view, the author is not a part of the story. I mean, not a character of the story. But in first person narrative point of view, the author or the narrator is a part of the story. Kindly remember this. Kindly try to understand this and remember this positively. Okay. Now, number five. The hermit was known for his dash. I think the options were wisdom, strength, religious practices. What do you think? What will be the answer? You don't need to think. You need to go through the text thoroughly. Okay, you will get the particular word mentioned in the text. The hermit was widely renowned for his wisdom. Okay, the quality of having knowledge and experience, wisdom. The hermit was widely known for his wisdom. Now, number six. The palm tree starts to spread his wish around his dash. Remember, around his head where he has his fronds, which are considered to be his wings by himself. So the palm tree starts to spread his wish around his head. Okay, around his head. Now, number seven. The word intently means with keen interest and attention. I don't remember. I think other options were intentionally and carelessly, I guess. But those are wrong. The correct answer will be this one, with keen interest and attention. You can get this in your own book, actually. Number eight. The poet of the poem Palm Tree is, we all know, we should know, we must know this, right? Rabindranath Tagore. Always remember, I have said this 1,000 times. Please, the spellings, the names of the text of the author or poet, whatever you are reading, the spelling should be correct, the name should be correct. You can't write "the three questions has been written by Rabindranath Tagore," because I have received this type of answers. Very few, but yes, I received this type of answers. But don't do this. This is kind of disrespect. Okay. Now, last one. Number nine. You have already been answered, quote unquote. Dash said this to Dash. Who said this to who? Remember when the king, for the last time before returning from the forest, from the hermit's cottage, decided to go to the hermit and ask him for the last time about the answers of his questions. He went to the hermit, he asked, he requested the hermit to answer him, but what did the hermit say? You have already been answered. Then he explained the thing. So that portion, from that portion you will get to know about the speaker and who, to whom did he say about that. So the hermit said this to the king. If you face this type of questions in the upcoming examination, I would suggest you to write down the words only. The hermit, comma, the king. I will be able to understand, okay, what you are trying to say. You don't need to write the full sentence. You may just write the king, the first one will be the hermit, then comma the king. But write down the answers respectively, okay. Don't write haphazardly, okay. So that's it. These were the answers of today's worksheet. If you have already watched the video, I should have saved this in the beginning of the video. But if you have not submitted to today's worksheet, then it's okay. You have already watched it and know the answers, then it's okay, no problem. But if you have already submitted it, then please go through whether you have correctly filled up all the blanks or not, all the answers you have correctly given or not. Okay, these were really very important questions, and if any other doubt, anything, any confusion, please note them down. Note it down and ask me in the live class without any hesitation. I'm repeating this again and again because we are not going to get any other class before the test. Okay, for now, bye bye, and all the best.